You have all these ideas, and at this point, you should be wondering, which idea should I choose? Well, to answer that question, you have a lot to think about. Here are some of the considerations you should keep in mind. First, is your idea a painkiller or a vitamin? Painkillers address an obvious and functional need for users, while vitamins address users' emotional needs and are really nice to have. Now, both types, but especially painkillers, can lead to successful companies. For vitamin-type ideas, you'll need to figure out how to get your users to be sticky, so that way they continue to come back and use your product over time. The second thing you should look for is how easy it is to monetize the idea. Now, you don't need to monetize an idea on day one, but understanding how to make money out of the service or product is essential to building an enduring business. Next, is the idea simple? Can you explain your idea in just a couple sentences? For example, bagbarsteel.com is like Netflix, but instead of renting movies, you can rent, buy, or sell designer items. Law enforcement and judges might say the simplest explanation is usually the right or truthful one. And this should also be true of your product. Users should be able to describe the product and its benefits to other potential users easily. And here's where we get to the heart of the matter. Is your idea personally relevant? For example, you might be a diabetic and want to develop affordable and convenient blood sugar monitors for other diabetics. Now, don't underestimate this one. This is of great importance as it relates to how likely you are to persevere in the face of challenge, uncertainty, or worse, looming failure. You'll be more likely to see an idea come to life if you care about the idea in the first place. Now, another consideration for your idea is whether or not you can follow through on it. Think about your ability to organize a small team or a large team to execute on the idea. Can you get from A to B? Next, you should wonder if you have a large enough size of the market. You want a really big slice of the pie. The market just refers to your number of potential customers. You should be able to calculate a lower estimate as well as an upper estimate for your market size. If you're unfamiliar with market sizing, refer to the instructor notes. There's a resource link there. And finally, does your idea have a legitimate secret sauce? Does your idea leverage technology or patents in a unique way? Or do you have talent and capital that no one else would ever have? For Google, the secret sauce was the PageRank algorithm. The secret sauce has grown over the years to include many features that bring millions of page results in fractions of a second. Now that you have some considerations for what makes a great product idea, I'd like you to evaluate the idea for the Super Duper Shopping app. You can find a survey that's linked in the instructor notes. Once you've taken the survey, you can check this box to continue when you're done.